Hey guys, welcome to my video of SAPUI5 for beginners. So this is going to be a series of modular topics rather than a long video on SAPUI5. This is to make it easier for you to digest. On this entire course, we're gonna cover the fundamentals. We'll also build a working SAPUI5 application from start to finish. Alright, so before we proceed with SAPUI5, let's talk about SAP Fiori. So what is SAP Fiori and how is it related to SAPUI5? So SAP Fiori is the new user experience for SAP applications. In the earlier years, users of SAP used to connect to their system via SAP GUI. So it's an application based on computer desktop. In order to increase accessibility, SAP created SAP Fiori. So as of today, there's a 12,000 plus role-based application and it's still growing. And SAP is also a cross-platform and browser-based application, which means if you access it on desktop, you can also access it using a tablet or any mobile device. Alright, so Fiori uses HTML5, that's why it's responsive and lightweight. It also adapts to the screen size, that's why it's easier to use. For example, on mobile, text becomes bigger since the screen size is much smaller. And finally, Fiori is basically just a collection of applications built using SAP UI5. So any application developed by SAP are called standard or Fiori. A common mistake people believe is that Fiori requires S4HANA. HANA backend is not actually mandatory for you to run SAP Fiori. As long as you have a NetWeaver Gateway license, Fiori is actually free. Okay, now that we know Fiori is just a collection of applications created by SAP, we can now proceed to know what is SAP UI5. So what is SAP UI5? SAP UI5 is actually a client-side technology. UI5 is mainly based on HTML5, JavaScript, and CSS. So it means that the action takes place in the user's device. So unlike all the applications that the server usually handles the workload, UI5 is actually executed or downloaded on the device itself. While Fiori is the collection of apps, UI5 is a collection of libraries and tools. It is the tool that we use to build the application to run on the mobile device or desktop. So that's why the Fiori apps, the application built by SAP, are built using SAP UI5. SAP UI5 also uses MVC or Model View Controller design pattern, and it's also licensed under SAP. It's just that SAP is the only one who can contribute to the core source code. Otherwise, you need to contact them for support. So now we know what SAP UI5 and Fiori is, there's also Open UI5. Open UI5 is just the open source version of SAP UI5. It contains a subset of libraries and tools, so it means that not all of the libraries you can find on SAP UI5 is the same with Open UI5. Most of the time, libraries on SAP UI5 are the ones first to be released, and then the Open UI5 version will come after. And since it's open source, anyone can try to contribute to its source code on GitHub. Now we know the difference between UI5, Fiori, and Open UI5, let's now discuss the topics included in this series. Alright, so first up is we discuss SAP Fiori, UI5, and Open UI5. Then we'll go ahead and set up our development or trial accounts on SAP Cloud Platform. And then we'll also have a quick overview on SAP Web IDE and how to use it. Afterwards, we'll jump right into building a custom SAP UI5 application. But we'll also connect that SAP UI5 application to a remote backend service as our data source, and then finally, we'll try to deploy our application to SAP Cloud Platform. Okay, so if you still want to learn more about front-end development on SAP, I highly recommend you subscribe and hit that notification button, since I also plan to release some videos with regards to debugging and troubleshooting Fiori and SAPUI5. There's also a video series with the new SAP Web IDE, also known as the SAP Business Application Studio. I'll also go over OData version 4 and how you can use it with your UI5 application. Then we'll move on to writing test scripts or testing with UI5. And then finally to Fiori Elements. So Fiori Elements can actually cut down your development time up to 80%, which is a big help for you to speed up your projects and deploy them in no time. Okay, so while we're going through this series, make sure you comment down below what topic for SAP front-end development you want to learn. Alright, so why are we using SAP UI5? What benefit do we get from using it instead of plain vanilla JavaScript or HTML? First, it provides route handling. This enables us to create basic to complex navigation from one page to another. We can also pass parameters using route handlers. So this enables us to navigate the application with ease. Next is data models. It provides a layer of abstraction on your basic data operation like create, read, update, and delete. This also includes your OData, JSON, and XML models. UI5 also allows you easy data binding. You can update your data dynamically. No need to create each and every function for getting and setting your data. We can also use views. We can create nested or reusable views or fragments. Then we have localization. We can easily create translation for different language within our application. And then SAP UI5 also support drag and drop. And this enables us to create complex layout. And finally, since UI5 is responsive design, you can easily create applications that work on multiple devices with minimal effort. So in this section, you can now go ahead and create your trial accounts on SAP Cloud Platform. So just visit this URL, sap.com/, for my region, I'm on Southeast Asia, then /products and Cloud Platform. Then click on Start Free Trial. Then it will open up a pop-up screen, and then click on Register for Free. And then another tab will open up, and then just fill up the form and then wait for your confirmation email. So after you receive that email, make sure you verify your account. Once you verify your account, we can continue our next lesson. Alright, so while waiting for your new environment, I would highly suggest to install this Google Chrome browser extension called UI5 Inspector. It's officially developed by SAP, so go ahead and install that. We will be using this one a lot for real-time debugging and navigation on our application during runtime. So you can basically see what are the properties and data bindings of your controls using this tool. Alright, so once your trial account is active, go ahead and visit your Cloud Platform Cockpit, or in this URL, cockpit.hanatrial.ondemand/cockpit#home/trial. Okay, in here you can see a lot of helpful links and references, but we want to focus on the environment section. So you can find it when you scroll down below. Okay, so you can have here environments. So you can find two trial links in here, the Cloud Foundry and Access Neo Trial. So basically Cloud Foundry is for non-SAP integration projects like AWS, Azure, and Google Cloud Platform. Now we'll just focus on Neo Trial. So go ahead and click on that. Okay, so there are a few prerequisites or requirements for this series. It's highly recommended that you have some basic knowledge about HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. so you can follow through the exercises. Another helpful skill is about JSON or JavaScript object notation. Basically, it's a plain text formatted in a certain way so that we can easily understand our data of our application. Next is XML, since we'll be building views using XML. And that's all for the presentation. We're now gonna jump in and take a look at our final application we're building. Alright guys, so this is the application that we are building. We're gonna have a two-page application. The first page is listing all our orders from our remote backend server. In this page, we can search our order by its name. So let's try Asia. Okay, and then we also have the sorting capability. You can sort by customer name, gross amount, descending or descending. Sending customer name. Okay. We can also group the items in the table. So let's just group them by customer name. You can see it's sorted by customer name, Avantel, and then African Gold, Diamond Corporation. All of the data you can find in the screen are coming from our remote backend server. Okay, and then when we click order line item, we'll be directed to a details page where you can see the customer name, the order ID, and also some notes for that orders. And then below the details are the products or the products included under this sales order. After that, we'll also run through some basic navigation. So navigating from our main page to our details page and back. Okay. Although it looks simple on the surface, we'll actually go through a lot of fundamentals of SAP UI5. So hopefully, guys, you enjoy this series. So that's it for the introduction. Don't forget to like or subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.